Good to see you on this channel, Grace Channel. This is Pastor Grace Studdard, and today on Jesus Baby Club, we're going to be talking about parental blunders. Now, here are some parental blunders to avoid in raising Jesus babies. As Christian parents, we are faced with issues in our relationship with our spouses sometimes that, if not carefully handled, will definitely affect the future of our children. So, to secure the future of your children, there is need to avoid these parental blunders. What are some of these parental blunders? On today's talk, I'm just going to mention two. And in the next talk, we'll add another two to it. Just stay tuned to Grace Channel and keep watching our programs. If you have not subscribed to our channel yet, please remember to do that. And it's so simple, in case you don't know how to do that. It's simple and it's charge-free. I mean, it doesn't cost you anything, any money. Nobody charges you any amount of money to subscribe. It's free. So how do you do that? Below this video that you're watching, you see the red button that says subscribe. Just touch it. It's free of charge. Touch it and you see the bell that says turn on notification. You touch the bell and that will help you to always see our movies, our videos when it comes out. So you know how to follow up on all our videos. Thank you. Please do that if you haven't done it. If you have done it and you forgot to turn on the notification button, please turn it on now. And if you receive this video, give us a like and share it with others also, so that they will also avoid these parental blunders, so we can continue to raise Jesus babies for the Lord. Hallelujah. All right, so what are some of those parental blunders that you need to avoid as a Christian parent? Number one, do not involve your children in your personal relationship with your spouse. What do I mean? Do not involve your children in the issues, the issues you're having with your spouse, especially when they are the one that's likely to break the home. You know, some homes are suffering some issues, and you see the parents bringing it out in the midst of the children. Yes, you may not have a trusted friend to talk to, but you can talk to your pastor and he'll be able to guide you the godly way. Now, some parents think that the best way to get back at their spouse is to let their children into the issues they're having with their spouse. At the beginning, it may just be a comfort zone. It may just be you and your children, you know, solidarity, your children sharing solidarity with you. But in the later on, you'll discover that it's not a good idea at all. We'll be giving you some of the consequences of what this could lead to. Now, let's bring it down for a better understanding. Some homes are suffering and at the edge of breaking down. You know, the devil does not like Christian marriages. He's fighting and doing everything to make sure that he scatters the home. You don't give him a room to do that. How? When you're having an issue, a fight, a quarrel with your spouse, don't let your children in. Don't bring them in. Yes, they are part of the family. Yes, they may even see it happening. They may even view it. They may be in their very presence. But don't involve them. Don't let them get involved. Don't let them get involved. How do I mean? Don't talk down on your spouse. That's the number two point. Don't talk down on your spouse in their presence. Yes, he may give you a word that is very hurtful. She may give you a word that is very hurtful. But don't reply in an hurtful manner in the presence of your children. Just swallow it and pretend you did not hear that word. Yes, later, when it's just you and your spouse, you can talk it out. Now, I'm not just talking to the women, I'm talking to the men also. Because the hurtful words, the fight, doesn't always come from the women, and that doesn't always come from the men. It can be from any of the spouse. So whichever it is, you have one of the partner walking out of a relationship, and then the children wants to know why mommy is not in the house anymore, or why daddy suddenly ran away from the house. And then you as the mother, because you are hurt, or you as the father, because you are hurt over the action of your spouse, you open up to your children, telling them everything. You may even end up exaggerating. But even when you are saying the truth, it is not a good step to take. Let me tell you why it's not a good step. It will come back to you in many ways. I've said that number one, do not involve your children in the issues you're having in your spouse. And I said number two, do not talk down your spouse in their presence. Now, your doing that may give you a relief, may give you some calm that you have some support as your children are on your side. So the other one is just alone. So now they hate their your spouse. So now they don't want to hear anything about your spouse. And you are happy that you have kept the children to yourself. But you have to remember that you alone cannot parent those children. Parenting is a difficult task. And the presence of the father and the mother in the raising of children makes it a lot more easier for us to raise children and to raise godly children. Remember, we're not just talking about raising children, we're talking about raising Jesus babies. So you talk to them and now they are angry with the other spouse. They don't want to talk to the other spouse. They don't want to see the other, your partner. They don't want to see, even if it's their father or their mother, they don't want to hear anything from him. So they keep away from him or from her for a very long time. And you're happy that you have secured your children only to yourself. They have lost the love that they had for your father. But what you don't know is that, one, you are sowing the seed of hatred in those children. You have just taught them to be hateful. And remember that they are too young to carry that hate in them. Remember that they are too young. The Bible says that whoever will cause this little one to sin, it is better that a rope is tied to the person's neck, attached to a rock, and then put into the sea to drown. So that even when the person is trying to struggle to come out of the water, the stone pulls him down to make sure that he drowns in the water. Now that is how difficult and how dreadful your punishment is if you lead these children into hatred. You sow the seed of hatred, of discord in their mind, and make them to begin to hate that partner. This is a partner that shares the same blood with them. You have developed hatred in those children, and that is not healthy for them. That is not a fruit of the spirit. It is a fruit of the flesh. You have turned these children to carnal children, to hateful children, to demonic children, because hate is not of God. Number two, apart from making them hateful, you have also taught them to be unforgiving. Because you have refused to forgive your partner, you have involved your children in the process, and you have taught them to be unforgiving, to not to forgive their father or their mother, depending on who is involved in this. Now, unforgiveness is not of God either, because you have just brought the children to a position where they too will not be forgiven, where their own trespasses will not be forgiven. What did the Lord say about forgiveness? He said, when we forgive, our Heavenly Father will also forgive us. But when we do not forgive, our Heavenly Father will not forgive us also. Two consequences I gave you today, and I'm going to give you more consequences of your action. Number one, you have made your children very hateful. Number two, you have taught them to be unforgiving. And that, you know, is not a good thing. If you are raising godly children, you must teach them not to be unforgiving. You must teach them not to be hateful. And when you sow this seed in them against your partner, against your spouse, you are teaching them unforgiveness. You are teaching them hatred. So how do you keep them out of this? How do you avoid this blunder? It is to keep them out of your fights, out of your issues. And people say that even the tongue and the mouth, they fight. The tongue and the teeth, they fight. Sometimes you see the teeth, you know, biting the tongue. But they still settle because they still have to work together. So you may have issues with your spouse. It doesn't mean that you will not settle. But before you settle, before you get your mind to settling, you have to avoid spoiling your children with this terrible blunder. You have to avoid spoiling your spouse before your children. You have to avoid talking down on your spouse before your children. If you talk him down before them tomorrow, or you talk her down before them tomorrow, when he's correcting them, when he's trying to guide them as a father or as a mother, they will not take him seriously, because you have made him to lose, you have made him or her to lose respect before the children. So, two parental blunders to avoid. One, do not involve your children in your fight with your partner. Two, do not talk down on your partner before your children. May God guide you to do this, so that the seed of hatred do not enter your children, and so that unforgiving spirit do not enter your children also. Now, if you have watched this video, tell me, send me your comments on what you think on these 2 points to avoid parental blunders. And let it not be you caught up in that error of parental blunders. Thank you for watching this video. Please share it with others. Give us a like and then subscribe if you haven't subscribed.